cluster. This is supposed to be for just staff zone. As you may know, I was sick and I went to a hospital last week. Sorry about that.
No, are you feeling better?
Yeah.
That's good.
Let's get started. As this session is about the implementation and the challenge of IVOed in GCC and from engineering's view. For the outline, the comprises of three parts tonight here: implementation details and challenges. The first part is general ideas. It always looks good. It first defines IV uses and possible IV candidates, and compute the costs. After that, there is an algorithm to find the optimal state for IV candidate and use that candidate to rewrite the program. All looks good. For the first part, find IV uses. Let's take an example of this simple example based on a loop. This is the dump before the IVO passes. And first, GCC uses scalar evolution to find the induction variable defined in the loop. And what we need in IVO key is to find the uses of induction variable. So, colored in the red. There is a tricky part is scalar evolution only works on the basis of SSVAR, so we need to do more work to identify the induction variable address of array reference, like the uses 1. Okay, this is a general idea of how to find IV uses. And with the uses we found, and we try to add IV candidate, you will see we try to add candidate on the basis of use. We just guess the candidates are generally derived from the uses. For the first two, they are always added because they are standard one. And for the rest of the candidates, they are just derived from the uses. We can see with some rules, we strip the whole state, we remove the base part and add the corresponding candidate. One point need to be mentioned is that for now we don't have all flow in IVOPs, so all these candidates except the base induction variable will be computed in unsigned type so that we can ignore the overflow behavior. Okay, here comes the how to compute the cost. When we're talking about the cost, we are talking about how to express the use with the candidate and what it takes. So, basically, we can try to express each use with every candidate and compute the cost. Of course, for some use, it might be impossible to express with some candidate, so the cost will be infinite, and that's often a problem, just ignore it. So after the computation of cost, there comes an algorithm trying to choose optimal set for every candidate for this case. So we will choose the candidate. We will choose candidate 5 and 6 to express all the 3 uses. And hopefully this optimal set will have lowest cost. After that, we will rewrite the program. The statement colored in red is in the new form after rewriting. As we can see, the several optimization in IVO, which is IV elimination and the strength reduction and induction variable merging are all done by rewriting program. This is where the algorithm in GCC is different from the classic IVO, because the classic IVO generally handle is different optimization in separately, but GCC handles it in a whole problem as a whole problem. Okay, let's come to the details. For find induction variable uses, we classify induction variable uses into three kinds. The first one is primal one, and the comparison one, and the address type. For the address type, there are address from memory references, and the comparison type induction variable generally appears in comparison conditions, and the rest of them are considered normal. For example, let's have an example. Okay. The hard part is the address type. There are several bugs reported that GCC failed to recognize the induction variable from memory references. The problem of this comes from the scaling rule, because originally scaling evolution doesn't compute accurate overflow information, and without overflow information, we failed to derive induction variable for address for the address expression. Let's take a look of an example. For the first function, the address of the array reference is actually an induction variable, but for the second one, it's not, because the address of an array reference using the index k actually wrap with respect to the loop. It's not an induction variable. So without accurate overflow information, IVO can only be conservative in this case, and skip most cases, even in the first one. Fortunately, this has been fixed a couple of months ago, and the bugs mentioned here are all resolved. We will see that we still need overflow information to do more work in later. After finding induction variable, we need to add induction variable candidates. As a matter of fact, it's quite primitive how GCC adds induction variable candidate. It's just a case from single IVOs, but that's not very good. It has several defects, as mentioned in this PR5.272. Sometimes useful candidates are not added, and sometimes useless candidates are added, and this causes other problems, because the algorithm is expensive with respect to the number of candidates. Also, it can mess up the candidate algorithm, resulting in suboptimal IV set choosing. Okay, the challenge here is we need to add candidate by studying the induction variable uses, by studying all the induction variable uses, not just the guess from the single IV uses. Let's take a look at an example. For this example, there are several uses. As we can see, they are almost the same except the base part. So for this case, we need to study all these uses to add the right candidate that we can exercise the CSE opportunities here. And talking about this, we also need to to take consider of target dependent issue because different targets support different addressing modes. For x86, it has a powerful addressing mode and this won't be a problem, but for targets like ARM and L64, it really suffers from this because we only support some kind of addressing mode and not that powerful as x86, and we found many regressions caused by this. Also, another case is for this example, each inductor variable use is one element after the previous one. For this case, we don't need to add a candidate for each use. We just need a generic one and to use the offset, register offset addressing mode. And yes, that's it. Here comes how to compute cost. It's hard to compute cost at early compilation stage, especially when you need to compute RTL cost on GIMPO. And for the first one is we need to lower high level IR as much as possible. For example, the array reference, the address of the array reference, we need to lower it to simple operations. It's always good to compute cost on GIMPO for these simple operations, not the high level intermediate representation. And we also need to cache RTL pattern and cost for saving compilation time, which might be not that good because it will result in inaccurate cost to some extent, but that's how it works. So we need to balance between compilation time and the result. We also need to make a target feature. This is the hard part. For example, the auto increment addressing mode support is never perfect in GCC now. We got performance improvement for ARM target, but when we try to enable it for X64, in some cases improved and others regressed. That means there must be something wrong with the cost model about addressing mode, auto increment addressing mode. And for do loop structure support, we haven't supported that in IVO at all. The problem isn't the cost itself. We know if the do loop structure can be applied, there will be one instruction saved at least. But the problem is it's hard to detect whether the loop can be it's hard to detect the do loop structure can be applied to a loop gimbal. Even looking at the RTL do loop pass. It uses lots of heuristic to check if the loop can apply the loop structures, but it's hard to model that on GIMPO. Okay, the target feature is hard to model, and the hardest one is the register pressure, as we know. But the IVO, as far as I understand, the IVO pass is the only pass that with a sophisticated register pressure model on GIMPO. And it does help a lot. Of course, it needs to be improved. It's very complicated, and I will leave it later. Okay, after that, we need an algorithm to find the optimal set. For this simple example, it starts with a small IV candidate set, which we want to handle the case with lots of induction variables. But generally, there is only one generic one, which want, so that we can keep the induction variable set small and also keep the register pressure small. So it always starts with a small induction variable candidate set and try to replace the expensive one with the cheaper one. During this process, it also proven IVO candidate set to keep it small. Of course, the algorithm also tried to break local optimal solution. So far, it's a heuristic algorithm and works for most cases, I can say. The challenge is the costs are entangled together, so makes the cost function very complicated. And another problem is the complexity issue. So we need to introduce compilation parameters based on number of induction variables instead of candidates. That's why we don't want to add too many candidates, because that will make the algorithm run slow, also a bad result. Okay, after all of this, we just need to use the candidate we chose to rewrite the program. It's simple. We compute the R uses with select candidate. We replace the old uses with a new one and just remove the dead code. We will see there are lots of progress in this step, actually. Here comes the register pressure. As we said, the register pressure model input is hard, and we only do cross-grained register pressure model here. And we don't model register pressure at every program point, and it's kind of impossible because of it's too early in compilation stage, and also because of SSA correlation problems, kind of impossible. So we don't model it at all. And we don't model register pressure for every register classes. We don't need that. We only classify the variables into integer and floating point. That's all we need. And the important part is we model register pressure on the basis of a loop. Let's take a look of a control flow graph, a loop, it's simple. We only model the live in register pressure, the live out, and also we need to model live through, which means defined before the loop and used after the loop, and maybe not used in the loop. And here is an example. Okay, for this example, we can compute the live in, live out, and live through information. And for induction variable optimization, we may rewrite the induction variable uses. In that case, we may eliminate some uses of variable. For example, the S4. Sorry. Let's take V2 as an example. In this case, V2 is the base of the array reference. And if we choose right candidate, we can eliminate the use of V2 by just using the start address of the array. So in this case, if we tween IVOP in this way, we can eliminate the use of V2 and decrease the register pressure. But on the other hand, we will introduce new register pressure because of this. This is how the register pressure is modeled in IVO. Well, this is how I expect the model of a register pressure in IVO, but we will see some problem. First one is it failed to restrict a number of IV set. First problem is rate suppression is inaccurate. Okay, for now we don't model the line out information for the loop in IVO. And the second problem is we don't classify the integer and floating point. We don't handle integer and floating point differently. That's a problem. And last problem, the third problem is the inimitable variables and the new variables have different cost. But for now, the cost in IVO they are same, but that's not true. It's quite straightforward because for the new variables, they are generally for induction variable. We at least, if we are going to secure this kind of variable, we at least do load it, add it, and store it, and sell it by store. But for inimitable variables, so we only, if we are going to secure this kind of variables, we only need to load it when we use it, right? So the cost is not the same. Okay, the last problem is the cost function fails at high rate pressure. We can see from this picture, the cost computed with respect to the induction variable number looks like this. The function becomes abrupt when on the verge of available register number. This is good because we want to constrain. We want to assign high cost to assign high cost to preserve a small injection variable set. But the problem is when the register pressure goes beyond this point, and the function becomes linear again. And when the function becomes linear, we failed to preserve the size of the induction variable set. The algorithm looks the algorithm looks to the candidate and see, oh, the cost increased not that much. So let's introduce a new induction variable candidate, and it keeps doing that and introduces more and more. Let's look at this example. This example is crazy because it chooses about more than 70 candidates for kernel loop inspect candidates. And with some tuning of this algorithm, the number can decrease to about 28, and there will be a algorithm performance improvement. Again, this hurts AR64 most. As we know, currently the risk suppression is modeled only for IVO purposes, but actually I think this can be extended to other loop optimization, especially the predictive coming pass and the stop motion pass in the LIM. But for that to pass, we need to model the live through information. It's expensive to compute live information at the exit of loop because actually what we want is not the live information, is we need to exclude the live information from the back edge of loop. What we need is the live information from the exit of loop to the exit point of program. Okay, this is the rate suppression patch of size and if we let's come to the next part, how to more precise overflow information. For now, GC can compute at a scale to be precise, and at the scale resolution can compute quite accurate overflow information, and we still need to exercise the overflow information in IVO. For example, there is one issue we need to use that information. Currently, GCC can't represent induction variable use with a candidate of small precision because it considers that the candidate has no enough precision to express the original use. This problem, the situation is even worse for target support the shift addressing mode but not the offset, offsetting the shift addressing mode. Once again, we are talking about ARM and x64. For this issue to be precise, for this example, that means we can't use the original induction variable t to express the array reference in the condition of the while loop. With the overflow information, we can prove that it's safe to do that even the t is of a type has smaller precision than the address. This is this is not working because there is conflict between overflow and induction variable elimination because the overflow information is computed with respect to the loop itself, but computed with respect to the loop's number of iterations. But the induction variable elimination needs to compute one step beyond the number of iterations. So we can guarantee that there is no overflow at the last step in operation. That's the conflict we are facing. So if we are going to use the overflow information, we need to skip some cases for induction variable elimination. Actually, just before attending this cauldron, I thought that the overflow is still the only solution to this problem. But on the first day, I heard the discussion between Michael Messner and Andrew Minsky, and they are talking about somebody is working on the type promotion and the demotion optimization that this can be a perfect solution to this, I think. I always mentioned that to promote the index of array to at least the precision of the size type. If we promote the index, the type of index to the size type, then there will be no problem for this because now we have the same precision for the index and the address. I will verify these two solutions, and I really think type promotion may be better. But of course,
the problem is type promotion can only be done in some limited cases. For instance, if a step in this case would be unsigned, you can't.
Yes. So
if t would be unsigned, you can't simply promote it to unsigned long, because then the addition would have to be a truncated.
Yes, so we need to be careful to choose which index can be promoted because if the index is used in some other cases, for example, in some expression which are of a lower type, then the promotion will introduce redundant type truncation. Right? So I guess we need to be careful about that. But anyway, there is no perfect solution. Let's see some problem with the rewrite program. We saw that the rewrite program could be very simple. We just need to rewrite the program with the candidate we find, but actually there are some problems with it. For example, the PR1830316. For general induction variable uses, we actually need to rewrite the induction variable just before the use. For example, on the left of this page is how GCC does it right now. It rewrites the induction variable too early, that it introduces a language conflict. If we do it like on the right side, we can compute the use just before the use, so there will be this registration.
Shouldn't we do that?
Oh,
we don't have pre after.
And the old RTL loop, I will open to that, but it's a long regression for tree RTL. And let's see a second one. It's in the same category, but for this time the use is actually outside of the loop. But for now we compute that use, compute the value inside the loop and keep it out of loop. So of course it also introduces an additional move and also increases the register pressure. Actually what we can do is to compute that value along the x edge. These two are the same. These two same problem, I think. I had a patch to fix these two problems, but to be honest, the address type induction variable is always the most important one. And this general type induction variable isn't that important. I didn't get any performance improvement from this. Okay, let's see how we rewrite address IVO use. Look at the left side. The statement colored in red actually is a problem, is where the problem is. When we rewrite the injection variable, we generally result in an expression, and for this expression, some part of this expression is loop invariant, and the other part is, of course, the injection variable itself. But you see, for this case, we first compute the induction variable with some induction variable. Sorry, we first compute the induction variable with some loop invariant, and that's the problem. What we need to do is first compute the loop invariant so that the coming loop invariant pass can hoist that loop invariant out of loop. But this is actually a reassociation problem. With this reassociation problem, the loop invariant will never be discovered and result in the bad assembly code on the right hand. And the last kind is the comparison induction variables. This is an example from a GC regression, GC
CC regression case, I think after induction variable optimization, the loop head best block is floating. But if we look closer to this case, we can find what it wants to compute is actually the A plus L multiplied by 4. This is what it wants to compute. But actually, it computed with this expansive expression. It first plus the S3 with L4 minus S3 minus 1 plus 1, whatever. So we can simplify this expression with loop initial condition. The first thing is we need to prove L4 minus S3 minus 1 plus 1 is equal to L4 minus S3. Okay, this can be done if we can prove L4 minus S3 minus 1 is 1 smaller than the high up bound of the loop, so that we will leave a whole flow by plus another one. And the second we need to prove is L4 minus S3 and convert to size type. The size type convert can be simplified into the operands. Again, this is also can be proved by the loop initial condition.
Colored in red.
computing loop invariants, and we failed to hoist it out. The problem is, as we say, IVO generate loop invariant during the computation and depend on the following LIM pass to hoist them out. But sometimes when we generate such loop invariant for the innermost loop, this loop invariant actually can be strength reduced by IVO for outer loop. After reduction, the cost is cost becomes small, and the following LIM pass fails to hoist them out. Here, what we want to do is guide LIM with register pressure information, and this time the register pressure information is quite easy to compute and use. We only need to model invariant. We only need to model invariant expressions as a forest of DSTs and model the rest pressure by counting the roots and the leaves of the forest. If the roots, the number of roots is fewer than the number of leaves, so we can consider it as a rest pressure decreasement. And for this forest, we can hoist all of this loop invariant out of the loop. With this example, actually, there are n roots and there are n plus one leaves. So by hoisting all these segments out of loop, we not only reduce the loop, we can also reduce the register pressure by one. I already had a patch for that and just need to submit for review later. Here is another example that the conflict between IVO and other optimizations. This time is the RTL loop on Euler. For the left side case, we can see the IVO result is quite simple, but the generated assembly code is not optimal because of the loop controller. There are several additional instructions introduced. In this case, it's about how RTL controller handles the induction variable. For now, it tries to split the long range of induction variable, but to get a short long range for possible register, but that may be true for old time, but not today, because on the GamePro IVO, we have already considered that each induction variable will take one register, and the induction variable is generally extensively used in the loop. Maybe it's better to keep the induction variable in its register and never to split it. So here, the idea is we don't split that range for induction variable in loop controller, and we factor this base pass index efficient mode out of memory reference and use the new base pass offset efficient mode so that we can avoid all these added instructions. It's always hard to compute the time-dependent cost of GamePro.
Well, I don't think that RTL unroller does a very good job in computing any costs.
Yeah, no.
Okay.
Though it's useful. Only because, well, there's two missing. One that had some do loop. That's the main reason.
Yes, that's another part, that's another method. Maybe you can try both, but this one is simpler. Yeah.
Why can't we just unroll, right before I or
structures will help you. Okay, thank you.